Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. We're still working on simplifying expressions as part of a bigger equation. So we have a formula, and we want to evaluate that by substituting values in. And in this case, I gave you all the variables that you needed. So n is 8, that's the number of trials, x is 3, p is 0.2, q is 0.8, and that's everything in there. So then we want to plug into this formula and simplify. And you might be easier if you plug in first and then put it into your calculator. What does an exclamation point mean? That's a factorial, and you'll use that when you're out in statistics. So I wanted you to get used to seeing some of the notation, and then x is 3. Then we have 0.2 to the third power, and q, whoops, not q, but q is 0.8. It kind of looks like a 0.8. To the n minus x, which is 8 minus 3. So looking at that, we have 8 factorial, 8 minus 3 is 5 factorial, 3 factorial, times 0.2 to the third times 0.8 to the fifth. That's probably going to be the easiest way for me to enter that into my calculator. So in this calculator, like every calculator, you have probably an option to use a fraction button if you're trying to get by through statistics with your phone. I highly recommend you don't unless you've downloaded an app for a good calculator on your phone. So here we go. I have a fraction and I have 8, and my factorial button in this calculator is right up there next to combination and permutation. And then I'm going to arrow down out of that. And then I have 5 factorial and 3 factorial. I don't need to put a times in between because it will know to do that. And then I'm going to arrow out of that. And I'm going to say times 0.2. Here's my power button. That sometimes is a little like caret button on your calculator. Oops, I did point. I don't want point. Three, I want 0.2, and then go up to 3, and then I'm going to times that by 0.8 to the fifth. And I'm going to get a long number, and I want to make sure that I have checked to see what I went around to. So it says up here in my directions, round to the nearest thousands, and that's 3 places out. So the answer that I'm going to get is approximately 0.147. That's going to be my approximation for this one. All right, so you just have to get practiced using your calculator. You don't want to put it in and then halfway through make notation and then halfway through make some other rounding thing, because that's going to lead to errors. The next one is a formula for margin of error, which you'll see in your statistics class. We have z with a subscript of alpha over 2, and that's the value of 1.96. That's your critical value. When you're taking stats, you'll see that. For now, we just want to plug into the formulas. And then we have n, we're given n, p hat, or we read that as p hat and q hat. Notice that they are add up to 1. Those are always, that's how that works with p hat and q hat, or p and q. And so we have those values. So we have everything we need here. So I'm going to go ahead and substitute into the formula. I get 1.96, and then I have the square root of 0.12 times 0.88. That's all over 40. So now I'm going to go ahead and put that into my calculator. I'm going to start with the 1.96. And then I'm going to put second function square root. And then inside that, I'm going to put a fraction. So I'm going to go ahead and enter that fraction. On the top, 0.12 times 0.88. And on the bottom was 40. And I enter and I get 0.1007. In this case, they again asked me to round to the thousands place. So my answer is, since I have a 0 in front, I want to put that 0, 0.1 0, 1. Now notice I'm putting a 0 in front because it's a good habit to do that. So on your quiz, on Canvas or whatever, you should be adding a 0. This is an approximate symbol written really strangely. But in both cases, the one before and this one, I added a 0 in front, which is a good habit. Okay, and the other one I want to do for you is the test statistic for a proportion. And I have given you, I think, everything you need for this one. But again, if you're not sure about what you're doing here, then you want to go to your stats formula sheet and see what everything actually stands for. But we're given p hat, we're given p. If we're given p, we know what q is because q is just 1 minus p, and we know n. I think we're good to go. You can always go back into your notes to see what that notation stands for. But I'm going to go ahead and write p hat 0.18 minus p, which is 0.15, and then over the square root of p, which is 0.15, and then q, remember q is always 1 minus p. So 1 minus p would be 0.85 here. And then that goes over n, which is 50. So I'm going to put that into my calculator this way. I'm going to start off by putting a fraction, because overall it is a fraction. I've got 0.18 minus 0.15 on the top. Down below I have a square root, and I have a fraction inside that. 0.15 times 0.85 on the top, and then I'm using my keys to go down or left or right, and then I have 50, and I hit enter. And now I have 0.5940885, whatever that is, and I have to see where was I asked to round. It says round to 4 decimal places. To 4 decimal places, I would get 0.5941. because that 8 would have me round up to one place. So this is approximately my answer for that. Okay, I think that's good. I think you can use your calculator now to simplify those equations. Have a fantastic day.